This is Ritanya.
And this is Ritan.
And welcome to our channel, The Last Reminds.
Today, we'll be learning
Exercise 1.3 from the chapter Real Numbers. Let's tune it out.
Hi everyone. Today, we are going to see 10th CBSE Real Numbers Exercise 1.3. Before going into the lesson, we need to know two theorems, that is Theorem 3 and 4 as per book. Theorem 3 states that if P divides A square, then P divides A too. That is, if P divides 9, then P divides 3. If P divides 16, then P divides square root of 16, that is 4. Theorem 4 is just square root of 2 is an irrational number. Okay, now with this we are going into the exercise. Let's go for the first problem. We should prove square root of 5 is irrational. For that, the first condition is we have to consider square root of 5 as a rational number. So, square root of 5 is equal to a rational number. What is rational number? Any number can be written in A by form is rational number. Here, A by B, A and B are co-primes. Okay? So, square root of 5 is equal to A by B and B go to the square root of 5 side. So, A is equal to square root of 5B. What is A squared? Square root of 5, the whole squared, that is 5B squared. Now, A squared is divisible by 5. So, A is also divisible by 5. Have you heard this before? Yes, it is theorem 3. When A squared is divisible by 5, then A is also divisible by 5. Okay? Are you clear with this? Okay. Since A is divisible by 5, I can write A is equal to 5C. Okay? I am writing this because A is divisible by 5. Okay? A is equal to 5C. Now you may ask, what is C? C is an integer. A and B are co-primes and C is just an integer. Now, I am going to take square of this. So, A squared is equal to 5C the whole square, that is 25C squared. Okay? Now, A squared is equal to 25C squared, A squared is equal to 5B squared. Therefore, 5B squared is equal to 25C squared. Right? Because both are equal to A squared. Now, I am going to divide this 5 and 25. 1 5 is 5 and 5 5s are 25. Right? So, B squared is equal to 5C squared. Now, again I am going to apply the theorem 3. If B squared is divisible by 5, then B is also divisible by 5. Okay? Now, we have A is divisible by 5 and B is divisible by 5. From this, what can you understand? Yes, A and B have common factors. But what we have said already, A and B are co-primes. That is, they don't have a common factor. They are co-prime. Okay? So, here we have come to a conclusion that A and B have common factors. But we have assumed A and B as co-primes. So, here a contradiction arises. Right? Here a contradiction arises. Why this contradiction arises? Because the first we have assumed square root of 5 is a rational number. This assumption is wrong. Okay? Since we have started the sum with a wrong assumption, we have ended the sum with a contradiction. So, we can prove that square root of 5 is an irrational number. Okay? Now let me explain the procedure again. Square root of 5 is rational. We are considering that is equal to A by B. So, A squared is equal to 5B squared. If A squared is divisible by 5, then A is also divisible by 5. We are using theorem 3. Since A is divisible by 5, I am taking A is equal to 5C, where C is an integer. So, A squared is equal to 25C squared. Now, there are 2 A squared. So, we are comparing 5b squared and 25c squared. Okay. Now we get b squared is equal to 5c squared. We are applying the theorem 3 again. So b is also divisible by 5 and a is also divisible by 5. So A and B have common factors 5. But A and B are co-primes. So this contradiction arises because of the wrong assumption that square root of 5 is a rational number. So square root of 5 is irrational. Clear? Now we should prove that 3 plus 2 root 5 is irrational. As I said before, we have to consider 3 plus 2 square root of 5 as a rational number. That is in the opposite case. Okay. Now we are considering 3 plus 2 square root of 5 as a rational number, that is A by B. Okay. Now 3 plus square root of 5 is equal to A by B. What you should do here is we have to leave the square root part one side of that equation and bring the other number to the one side. That is A by B minus 3. 3 comes this side. Okay, 3 comes this side. So A by B minus 3 is equal to 2 square root of 5. Now we all know A by B is a rational number. So A by B minus 3 is a rational number. When the LHS is rational number, obviously the RHS should be a rational number, right? So 2 square root of 5 is a rational number. What? Is square root of 5 a rational number? No. Square root of 5 is an irrational number. But we have come to a conclusion that 2 square root of 5 is a rational number. Is it contradictory? Yes. Here 2, a contradiction arises. Okay. This contradiction arises because we have assumed that 3 plus 2 square root of 5 is a rational number. So we have considered that is wrong. Okay. This contradiction arises because we have started the sum wrongly. So we can come to a conclusion that 3 plus 2 square root of 5 is an irrational number. Are you clear? So we have taken you have to prove it's an irrational. So we have taken that sum as a rational number, that is A by B. We are keeping the square root part on one side and the remaining part on the other side. We all know that A by B is a rational number. So A by B minus 3 is also a rational number. When LHS of an equation is a rational number, the other side must be a rational number. But we all know that square root of 5 is an irrational number. So here a contradiction arises. This is because we have assumed it wrongly. Okay? Okay. Now we can go to the next sum. We have to prove that 1 by square root of 2 is an irrational number. Here too we have to take that 1 by square root of 2 as a rational number. We have to assume it. That is equal to A by B. Now we should follow the same procedure as the first sum. That is 1 by square root of 5 is equal to A by B. That is B is equal to square root of 2 into A. Okay. B squared is equal to square root of A the whole square, that is 2A squared. Here we are following theorem 3, that is if B squared is divisible by 2, then B is also divisible by 2. Okay. Since B is divisible by 2, we can write that B is equal to 2C. Do you remember the first sum? Yes. Here C is an? Yes, C is an integer. A and B are co-primes and C is just an integer. Okay. Here B squared is equal to 4C squared. Since B squared is equal to 4C squared and B squared is equal to 2A squared, we can write 2A squared is equal to 4C squared. Okay. Now I am dividing 2 and 4. 1, 2 is 2 and 2, 2s are 4. So A squared is equal to 2C squared. Here too I am applying theorem 3 again, that is A squared is divisible by 2, so A is also divisible by 2. Here B is divisible by 2, A is also divisible by 2, but A and B are co-primes. When two numbers have same common factors, how can it be a co-prime numbers? It can't be, right? Here we have come to a conclusion that A and B have common factors 2 and we know that A and B are co-prime numbers. So here too a contradiction arises. This is because we have assumed that 1 by square root of 2 is a rational number. That consideration is wrong. We have wrongly started the sum. Therefore, 1 by square root of 2 is an irrational number. Now, let's go to the second question. We have to prove 7 square root of 5 is an irrational number. 7 square root of 5 is a rational number. This is how we have to assume. Therefore, 7 square root of 5 is equal to A by B. Therefore, A is equal to 7 square root of 5 into B. Therefore, A squared is equal to 7 square root of 5 the whole squared. That is 7 square root of 5B the whole squared. Sorry. So, 49 into 5B squared. That is 7 into 7. 49 into 5B squared. So, what is 49 into 5? That is 245B squared. Now, A squared is divisible by 245. So, what is theorem 3? Yes, A is also divisible by 245. Since A is divisible by 245, we can write A is equal to 245C. Here, A and B are co-primes and C is just an integer. Since A is equal to 245C, A squared is equal to 245 squared C squared. Okay. Now A squared is equal to 245 squared C squared and A squared is equal to 245 B squared. So we can write 245 B squared is equal to 245 squared C squared. Okay. Now we can cancel to divide 245 and 245 squared. So, B squared is equal to 245 C squared. Now, apply theorem 3. B squared is divisible by 245. So, B is also divisible by 245. Okay. Now, A is divisible by 245 and B is divisible by 245. So, we can come to a conclusion that A and B have common factors. Okay. But we know that A and B are co-primes. What do you mean by co-primes? They are prime numbers. So, they don't have a factors. Okay. But here we have come to a conclusion that A and B have common factors. So, again a contradiction arises because of the wrong assumption that 7 square root of 5 is a rational number. So, it's proved that 7 square root of 5 is a irrational number. Okay. The contradiction arises because we have assumed it wrongly. Okay. It's proved that 7 square root of 5 is an irrational number. Okay. Are you clear? Now, let's go to the final sum, that is 6 plus square root as an irrational number. We have to prove that. We have to start it with that. 6 plus square root of 2 is a rational number. We have to assume it and start the problem. So, 6 plus square root of 2 is equal to A by B, where A and B are co-primes. Okay. Now, what we should do? We should keep the square root part in one side of the equation and keep all other things in the next part. That is, A by B minus 6 is equal to square root of 2. Now, we all know that A by B is a rational number. Yes, A by B are rational number. Very good. So, A by B minus 6 is also a rational number. Yes, I too accept that. If LHS of the equation is rational number, then RHS of that should be a rational number, right? So, A by B minus 6 is a rational number. Yes, we all know that. So, square root of 2 is also a rational number. Is it correct? No. According to theorem 4, we know that square root of 2 is an irrational number. But we have come to a conclusion that square root of 2 is a rational number. So, a contradiction arises between the theorem 4 and our conclusion. Right? This is because we have assumed 6 plus square root 2 is a rational number and that is wrong. So, if the assumption 6 plus square root of 2 is a rational number is wrong, then obviously what is correct? 6 plus square root of 2 is an irrational number. Okay? Are you clear with that? Now, if you repeat this video again, then all these things will be strongly recorded in your mind. Okay, these are easiest sums. Okay, the same theorem repeated in different ways. Okay, here we have to start the sum with the different assumption, and we have to conclude that there comes a contradiction, and we have to correct our assumption. That's it. Okay, with this exercise 1.3 is over, and we can continue 1.4 in the next video. Okay, if you have any doubts, please comment below, and I'm here to clear your doubts. Okay, whenever you have free time, practice Max. Make a connection with Max, and Max will connect with you. Meet you all in the next video. Till then, signing off. Parveena Ramesh. Bye-bye.
Subscribe, hit the bell, leave a like.